Hey everybody, how's it going? I wanted to show you my Ultimate Cinema Edition aerial kit that I got from DSLRpros. Here's my Phantom. Really nice piece of equipment. And right underneath here, we have the Zenmoose H3 2D gimbal. And included with this kit is also the GoPro Hero 3 Plus Black Edition. My first GoPro. I have very limited experience with remote control devices, so I went to a hobby store and picked up a quadcopter. It's made by Hubsan, I believe, so I've been practicing on that. It seems that I'm charging the battery a lot more than I'm flying it, but that's kind of how it is. So what I want to do is show you some of the items that are here in this case, and then I'm going to show you the battery charger that came with this kit as well. And here's the case that the Ultimate Cinema Edition aerial kit came in. Here sits the Phantom. Here's the Futaba T8FG Super transmitter. It's really awesome. 14 channels. Boy, you wouldn't want to sit on that. Oof. And I have the Black Pearl 7-inch HD FVP. Screen. Check that baby out. Yeah, pretty nice. Okay, here's the QuantumPro Q1 Plus battery charger that came with my aerial kit. I found the balanced extension board, which is this thing right here. That's one of the accessories you need with that to charge your battery. Also necessary, the power lead adapter cord, which have the banana plugs right here and right here. Grab the charger and in the red port insert the red banana connector and do the same for the black one. Insert that into the black port. Now you want to go ahead and take your balanced extension board and connect it to the white port. Here's the battery I'll use as a demonstration here. And here are the wires that come out of it that you need to connect. And put it on the 3S port right here on the board. Then you can go ahead and plug your yellow plugs together. So now you're connected fully for this battery type right here. It's pretty easy. Now you can go ahead and get your power cord. And here we go. We want to make sure that we're going to put in the correct battery type. Press this far left button here. Select the correct battery that you're trying to charge. Just keep pressing it until you get to your battery type. In my case, I need the LiPo battery. I'm going to hit enter. My mode right now is LiPo charge. Well, for the battery that I have, I want it to be on balance. So, in order to change that mode from charge to balance, I'm going to hit this button here and go there. Now, if you didn't want this choice, you can continue to hit this right button here and scroll through. And you can pick any of these options. And I want it on balanced. I'm going to go right here and hit enter. And when I do that, then I can change the amperage here. If I needed to lower it or make it higher, I can just do the left button here and decrease it. Or if I need to increase it, I can hit this button here, the right. And for this battery, it's recommended to be at 4.0. So I got where I wanted to be, hit enter. And if you need to make any changes here, you do the same thing with your left and right. But in my case, I know that I'm doing a 3-cell. And then hit enter. And now you're set for this particular battery that I'm charging. And hit the enter button here and just press it until I get this screen. Battery check weight. So it's read at 3S, I input 3S, that looks correct, hit enter. you're ready to charge. It's charging right now. And when it's done, it'll beep at you. What you want to do now is disconnect your battery. So here are the steps. Take your yellow plugs and disconnect them. And then your balance lead connection to the board. That needs to be taken off next. Your battery's disconnected now. Disconnect your electricity. And there you go. It's that simple. So that gives you just a small demonstration of the QuantumPro Q1 Plus battery charger. So I'll bring back out my Phantom, and I'm going to share with you the screwed up story. All right, so yesterday I thought I would go ahead and work on these prop mounts here. I painted these two right here yellow, and my intention was to place them on the front of the Phantom like this, so that way my propellers would be guarded. So I went and got an Allen wrench set, and I got the right size. The instructions were to take out the screws on the outside underneath the motor. I did a screwed up thing. I stripped two screws already. So what I did was I called DSLRpros and I told them the whole story and kind of, ooh, what do I do now? Yeah, obviously they can repair it, and it's not unheard of having strip screws coming to them, and then they take care of it. Then I'll need to ship it back and have those two screws taken out and replaced. So yeah, I was pretty pissed off yesterday when all of this happened. So I hadn't even taken it up in the air yet. You know, this baby was a lot of money. Just be cool with it. I need to practice on this baby. If I'm already stripping screws and can't fly this, I'm in a lot of trouble. So keep tuned for future videos on my experiences with my Phantom, the Ultimate Cinema Edition aerial kit from DSLRpros. I think I'm gonna have a good time with it, so see ya.